Welcome to this 38th session of Ergonomics for Beginners Industrial Design Perspective. The current module is module number 9, Performance Support and Design Intervention, with the fifth classes in this, total 5 classes. This today, the current session, class number 38, the vertical arm reach and relevant design application possibilities, workstation craft sector. Gist of last session, whatever we have discussed in last class, we have discussed 4 design ideation exercises were discussed that satisfy specific requirements and examples shown as a multipurpose hostel table, a mobile lecture delivery assistive trolley, a student's classroom drawing table with seat stand facility, a school classroom seat desk furniture design. These were discussed in last classes. And in summary, whatever we discussed, it can be said that the design development attempt must have proper need identification followed by design ideation exercise and incorporation of context specific human compatibility and comfort issues. Similar to the above mentioned concepts that we have discussed in last class, in class number 37, the relevant need-based and anticipated need-based design ideation exercises may be initiated to meet our varied nature requirements. So, with this background, the today's session, the class number 38, we are going to discuss vertical arm reach and relevant design application possibilities and ergonomic workstation for craft sector. We are going to discuss in this area that brass metal activities. In earlier sessions, we have discussed body dimension match relevant issues and ergonomics criteria that influences design. The present deliberation focuses on some workstation application of vertical arm reach. So, this today's discussion we are dividing in 2 groups. The first part is that vertical arm reach related, and second is a workstation or a metal, brass metal craft. So, in earlier sessions, we have discussed this arm reach values and etcetera, and now in this, we are just giving a total some recollection of those issues. Like in this figure, in a machine condition, work condition, it says that the task should be within the arm reach. Means what's happened? That normally it is said that if this is within 150 degree angle, then one can perform skillful move activity. So, it would be better to keep all the controls of the machine or wherever you need to touch it, maybe upper shelf, etcetera, it should be within that limit. Now, if you stretch, then in this figure it says that the person taking books from the top shelf with a stretching body, the upper, the maximum, using maximum upper arm reach, here it is very difficult to select specific books and handle very carefully while taking out, that book may fall or something like that. So, then what can be done here? Either provide some support so that the person can raise up, or design something so that these books, etcetera, it will be within the easy reach. Now, this comfortable arm zone here, it is also said that the same thing, not only that upper arm reach, the lower arm reach also required that around 20 millimeter gap to be ensured at the below, so that stress will be less. This part we have already discussed earlier, but now here we are stressing on that work posture requiring considerations for upper and lower limits of comfortable arm reaches have to be ensured, where we need to perform some skillful activities. Earlier we have discussed that arm space envelope and the total arm arc and the vision arc. So, with that this type of some rack design is possible, where the total surface area will may be as a curved appearance and the topmost will be within arm reach. So, consider physical workspace envelope for such concept generation. Then what is the human body envelope, workspace envelope? The if a person stands, here and from the if and this is the vertebral is a main axis, central axis, and so the different parts if you make in three different plane like that, if this is the plane we are mentioning, so then right side and left side will be there, and then if we see this much this direction, then back and front, and if we have a transverse section, then it covers upper and lower portion, and then all these arcs are the arm arcs. Means what happened? The when we raise our arm, extend our arm, and then this is like this, this is the total arm arc at different heights, I get it. So, the bilateral human body is described in terms of three reference planes to describe various locations and directional motions corresponding to body position. Functional human volume is a space as shown above by arc lines of arm reaches at different heights and the various positions over the floor, where a man performs tasks without distracting the attention of the central work area. Some examples: height fixing the top platform requiring easy reach height, and here it should not be the full vertical arm reach. Now, the total workspace if we see for this purpose, then the bending space, height, reach, lower reach, etcetera has to be considered. In this case, not only all the tasks are performed on a ground level, sometimes what happens, the task requiring climbing. Now, in this climbing, after climbing and working at the above head level. So, at this position, what will be the controllable upper arm reach? If this arm is extended beyond around 150 degree angle normally, then some additional stress appears. So, it should be like, so then with that either you increase the support system or you decrease the working point, or have a design in such a way that the task can be performed nicely. So, for general dimensions, now whatever you are discussing, it requires some dimension, then where with these dimensions available. So, in this slide, some specific anthropometric dimensions are provided here for male and female combined data source. Here, 50th and 95th percentile values are provided, and all the terms are given in this side here. So all dimensions, measurements are values are in millimeter, and this source, here some of the data are presented here, but for a full range of Indian anthropometric data source, you can have from anthropometric dimensions in standing posture, Indian male and female combined data, 5th, 50th and 95th percentile values in millimeter. The source is that Indian anthropometric dimensions for ergonomic design practice by D. Chakraborty, published by National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad at 1997. So, that from that data one can use for new design development. And this is a display layout workplace, physical reach and easy vision to be established. Suppose in this case, if a person's height is this much, then for him to lean here to and to select some material will be little difficult. In that case, a concern comes whether we can have a curved surface like this, so that it will be easier to reach, as well as vision control will also be there. So, with this, the vertical arm related issues, now we are shifting to ergonomic polishing workstation, that is design of user friendly new brushware polish machine. So, some background is that the polishing of brass metal product as Hazo, that is in Assam near Guwahati, the cluster in traditional way sitting on ground mostly with manual work like all other craft item production is done. So, after studying the total production cycle from metal sheet cutting to finished product, a specific need was identified where a shift of work style can be considered for better productivity and working better maintained. A new workstation with elevated work surface for brassware polishing purpose was developed for 2 persons, and when power supply is there, single person can use the system. What does it mean, the content of this slide? In Hajo area in Assam near Guwahati, a cluster is there, they make this brassware. Normally, they collect the material, raw material from market, and then they do all the necessary steps towards making a final product, like bowl, vessels, plates, pots, etcetera, various sizes and shapes. Now, it is found that all the activities are being done in a sitting position on the floor. So, a concern comes how their productivity can be increased and their work can be smooth enough. So, their each and every activities were studied from ergonomics point of view, and after that one concern came that all other activities concerning this brassware making are performed by single person, but for the brassware polish it requires 2 persons. Brassware polish means the after making the pot or whatever or thali, it has to be put in a shaft, it rotates, one person pulls that thread to rotate that thing, and another person sitting opposite, they hold a knife in hand and they chisel out the layer, so that it becomes a polished metal. Means when the brass wire is moving and then he is touching with this blade, that knife, cutting knife, so it chiseled out one layer and by that it is polished. So, here what has happened? They are interdependent. If some person stops this pulling the shaft for rotation, if he stops, then the person who is using the knife, his activity also stops like that. So, it is interdependent. So, a situation come while discussing with them, a suggestion came that if we can elevate the workstation so that they do not require to squat or sit on the floor, a good workstation can be developed. So, this workstation was developed and it was found good with the field trials and etc. So, now we are going to say this in development process. Task performed by single persons, all the tasks are shown here, everywhere all the tasks pertaining to the brass metal production, all the tasks are being done by single handed and finally, the product appears here. Now, this product needs to be polished. And here the bottleneck comes, because two persons are necessary for that, and among all the activities it becomes time taking. This is the typical area, typical figure showing how the polishing is done. So, one person is pulling this shaft, and this is the brass wire fitted here, and with a knife it is being polished. So, polishing by two person tasks like that, one is pulling the thread and another person sitting opposite side it is polishing. So, whatever idea came, first a 3D prototype of polish machine for brass metal artisans to polish a number of brass metal products were developed. Means first what we made a 3D model in computer, and after getting a certain feedback from the users after showing that thing, we made it a full prototype. And while making this direct prototype, we asked those people to come there and to assist in the making, so that all the modifications and their suggestions can be incorporated in modifications. Now, participatory approach for development as well as usability evaluation of polish machine was done. Like here, this figure say that while making this model, they are the actual artisans. They were called and invited to the laboratory and to assist in this process. Now, after fixing, then their trials were also given. Now, the thing is that this is the actual product, the workstation was developed, means it is a higher platform, one side is a cycling facility, where that this has one can adjust it height and then angle, this is the handle. So, there are this, and here the main brass metal may be placed here, and is so, and a motor was provided here. If power is there, then through motor this shaft can rotate, and only one person can polish the machine from this side. When power is not available, mostly what happened, why this thing was done, because in the craft section areas are normally outskirts of the city area. So, there the power, the electricity availability is not always good. So in that case, this manual as well as electrical, both the facilities are provided. So from opposite side, we can say that in this case, in here, the person can use a chair kind of thing here, any kind of chair, he can use, sit and work. We do not need to squat always. And here a special guided knife holder is given here, which cutter holder, so that after holding here, he can operate it with this thing. Now, in earlier session, in earlier the while working the floor, at that moment while cutting it, the arm remains in a suspended position, so it puts a pressure load on this on body. Here what happens with this, a holder is provided, so arm support is there, and with arm support one hand, you can move like this wherever the cutter is necessary, and then it can be cut. So it's a holder, a support system is been used here. Now this new workstation, the features are the elevated work surface, automatic and manual power both. Increases productivity and comfort, free postural facility. We gave this product to the artisans, they kept it for 6 months almost, and then we got their feedback, and it says that it increases around 75% of productivity, means by the counting the products polished. And free postural facility means they can sit, they can stand, the person who is holding the knife, and when power is there, single person can work, so we do not need to cycle to move that shaft. So it is a free postural change for facilities are there. The cycling to rotate shaft and polishing person can use sit stand posture and a tool holder. Using optional but motor, single man can do the polishing task. So, the subjective and productive performance by counting the number of polished material, and ergonomic evaluation was carried out while working with newly adopted polish machine and with traditional one, that is sitting on the floor. Results shows benefits of the new workstation design. Now, subjective means by asking them a questionnaires, and productive performance by counting the how many products they can polish. Now, ergonomic evaluation was done here, two specific items like that, like physiological parameters and electromyography records. Now, while working, after selecting the major muscles relevant to perform this task, from that electromyography records were taken from the this puller as well as here the other persons who is using the cutter. And also we have taken that how much energy is being spent for this task using the oxygen consumption. Oxygen consumption what happened, that with a mask, the air goes to a digital equipment placed on the back. So, it gives the result of when in the air oxygen quantity or the oxygen available in the normal air, and with the exhaled air, what is the oxygen in that. So from that, the total oxygen being used for this task, from that the energy expenditure is being calculated. So, by this way, the energy expenditure and the muscle electromyography was taken of this traditional style of working. And then while using this new machine like this, the person here with a cutter, he can hold it, and with this the knife holder here, he can modify wherever he needs to touch this. So, here also the major muscles required for this task electromyography record was also taken, and the oxygen consumption for the cycling person, for him also the electromyographic records were taken, and oxygen consumption also was taken for, as is shown here. So the result, that means energy expenditure for a specific time of working on this machine, and in the traditional method of working sitting on the floor, the difference is that this machine gives a better performance. So, design of user friendly new polish machine developed by ergonomics laboratory IIT Guwahati as a part of PhD research project. So, till now whatever we discussed in this workstation development, both persons need to work, but some special facilities have been developed here. If power is there, then we do not require this person, only this person can perform the task. When power is not there, then this person may be added. Now, question comes, why we require two persons? Can we develop a system for a single person's use? The further work was carried out. Means this was the development was done. Then we got the influence from the sewing machine. So, from this sewing machine operation, the idea came, and this product is developed, is further development for single person's use, that machine. Here what happened, the both sides there. So, here we do not require any holder kind of thing like this, any holder kind of thing, because here with this area from this side or from opposite side in this, he can put the elbow and then he can hold the knife and can polish it here. So, that was reduced to that component. Now, when motor is given here with a special cover and with a special speed controller here, so that with a speed control we can polish as desired pressure and desired speed is necessary. Here one cloth cover is given here like that. So, what happens while polishing, whatever that brass particle falls, it may be easy to collect it here. When this power is not available, power failure, then using simple swing type of machine facility with leg movement, this work can also be continued. So, this type of development was done considering that a single person's use. Now, from another viewpoint, it is seen that this is the motor area, how the motor is fixed, the chain and the person sitting. Here any kind of tool or chair can be used with this machine. So, after this development, it was discussed to the expert group while demonstrating live, the feedback was taken and then the final modifications was done. So, these are the issues where not only to develop a product, design developed must be evaluated if the desired effect has been achieved. So, the laboratory facility is necessary. In earlier exercises of that workstation design, we mentioned that oxygen consumption and others like electromyography records and others, just I mentioned only two, but some others are also considered there. So, now the what facilities are necessary normally for such type of product evaluation. There are many things, but for a typical ergonomics laboratory, these facilities are necessary to be there. Like facilities is in required for setting of a laboratory facility for this evaluation is that for common equipment in laboratory to study anthropometry, body dimensions, anthropometer set to study and evaluate product and user's geometric compatibility. There are also some other grids and etc. may also be used. User's psychophysical status, a fit kit and evaluation set means to understand or to assess the physical status of that person, meaning heart rate, body temperature and others. Like environmental assessment, where the person is working, what is the environmental load on him. For that, a set of equipment to assess physical work environment like heat, humidity, ventilation, illumination, etc. and vibration and their effect through the physiological parameter to assess it is that workload and work tolerance limit like pulse rate monitor, oxygen consumption measurement for energy expenditure, computerized physiological recording system is necessary. Means we may require to know that different blood flow, pressure, torque, force, etc., pull, push force, like that, and then angle measurements of different body while working, and then audio visual performance and signal output perception. Like audiometer to know the hearing, visual field and color angle measuring devices, etc. Videography based design and human movement as biomechanics analysis, etc. are need to be performed. There are many ergonomic softwares where the video after recording videography, the total movement, angle and etc. can be analyzed. So, now normally the typical work posture, anthropometric measuring methods, these are the some of the equipment for environmental assessment like globe thermometer and other environmental meter, etc. Then come this is the oxygen consumption meter, because while sitting or doing some task, what is the oxygen, the energy expended that can be used, measured like that while sitting or standing, walking like that. Now, the concerns are applied ergonomics aspects, usability evaluation and participatory ergonomics aspect, means for whom we are doing to get their input. In this, it is shown that a car being analyzed for its users while using it, what facilities and what problems they face and what facilities are required to be there. For that, some study going on in laboratory, this figure showing that ergonomics analysis of applied force to car controls like that, where the with different pressure gauge and etc. through computer that will record can be done. Like while developing this type of design, usability evaluation using videography means the person when they are doing the from different corners. If we take the videography and we present on a gridded line, gridded box, that directly one can recognize the work posture and etc. also, as well as this video recording can be analyzed through computer using various softwares. Now, computerized physiological parameters recording, like when you are holding in this right hand, this left hand top corner, this figure shows a computer monitor figure shows that while holding a specific new developed handle, while holding it, the pressures and etc. and how it is really fit or not, that part can be done. And some of the equipment are showing here that is being that one can use for electromyography recording, electrocardiography recording, electromyographic recording, even eye oculography, eye movement, etc. And then heat, different heat and other resistance of the body like that, everything, all these things are necessary to carry out for evaluating a design. Here just showing that one figure that students are using or being taught the how to use the anthropometric rod set, and for that different physiological recording using computerized method here, that EMG recording was being demonstrated to the student. Now, with this we can say that ergonomics has become a business promotion word that we hear so often these days, particularly in the high-tech industry tagged to their products to increase the sale, because users, without knowing, if the after seeing that ergonomic tag, they feel that it is good one. But ergonomics is a way to work smarter and not harder, and it can be achieved by designing tools, equipment, workstations to suit intended tasks as well as leisure time requirements. The design features are not only to divulge ease of use and safety, the functional needs, but pleasure of use, enjoyment of the experience. It should be aesthetically appealing and dimensions matching with user's features. Aspects of pleasure beyond functionality, which today is an emerging issue in the field of design ergonomics. A good ergonomic design creates a context for experience that fully respects users' all inbuilt capabilities and acquired skills, and understands users and their requirements. So, with this, we are concluding today's session, vertical arm reach as issues and the workstation development possibilities in a normal craft sector, where people used to work following the tradition sitting on the floor level. Now, a trial was given if the work surface can be elevated up with some other facilities, so that a workstation can be provided for certain purpose, and that was achieved. So, now with this we are concluding this today's session. So, thank you.